You know, there's a lot of videos on YouTube touting the Godox SL60W as an Aputure 120D killer. Now, is it an Aputure 120D killer or just a killer bargain? We'll find out in this video. Stay tuned. First of all, the Aputure 120D is an industry standard. It's used by professional videographers, photographers, filmmakers, and top YouTubers like Peter McKinnon. But it's specifically designed for professional use. But the cost of the 120D, for the most part, puts it out of reach for the average consumer. The Godox SL60W, on the other hand, is reasonably priced, making it an affordable option for budget-minded creators looking to upgrade or supplement their existing lighting equipment. Here's the price of the 120D paired with Aputure's Light Dome Softbox. And here's the price of the SL60W paired with a Glow Parabolic Softbox similar to the Light Dome. Besides price, there are other differences between the Aputure 120D and the Godox SL60W. The Aputure 120D has a rugged aluminum body designed for professional use. It also has dual power. It can be plugged in AC power in the studio, or there's a V-mount battery option for use in the field. This makes it slightly more versatile than the SL60W. It's also more powerful than the Godox, and it's brighter. It also has a CRI, color rendering index, of 96. Anything above 90 is excellent. Like the Godox, the 120D is daylight balanced. The Godox SL60W has a plastic body. It's a sturdy plastic body, but it's still plastic. The SL60W is AC power only. There's no battery option. However, Godox does offer a battery-powered version of the light at a price of $349, a lot more than the $134 price of the SL60W. The Godox also has a CRI above 90, coming in at 93. Although the Godox is not as powerful as the 120D, it provides more than enough power and brightness for most uses, especially for YouTube videos. Now, I'm currently using it at 30% power through a Glow Parabolic 20-inch softbox with a grid. And I'm shooting at ISO 100 at f2.0. And as you can see, it's plenty of light and it gives a great quality of light. One knock on the Godox SL60W is the fan noise. It can be especially audible if the mic is near the light, especially in situations like an interview. However, I found it fairly easy to remove in post. As long as you keep the mic a good distance from the light, such as with a wireless microphone, the fan noise is negligible. So is the Godox SL60W a 120D killer? I don't think so. I think they're made for different markets. The Aputure 120D is designed primarily for professional use. And if you're purchasing it for daily professional use, it's easy to justify the price. But at this price point, the Godox SL60W is an excellent light for anyone on a budget, including beginning videographers, filmmakers, or YouTubers. And it provides a great quality of light when combined with an endless variety of Bowens mount light modifiers. If I had the money, I might move up to the Aputure 120D. But for right now, this Godox SL60W suits my needs just fine. Within the last few weeks, Godox came out with a new line of video lights, the VL150, the VL200, and the VL300. These are just now becoming available at B&H and Adorama, and the VL150 starts out at $399, and they're priced upward from there. Well, that's all for this video. I hope this video gave you some idea about the Godox SL60W. And although it may not be a 120D killer, it sure is a killer bargain. It's an excellent light for the money. Thank you for watching, and if you found value in this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Until then, we'll see you in the next video.